you know, do all of you participate as a formal part of society, but I know many of you do things on your own as well. I had the honor back in September of participating in the dedication of the Gold Star Memorial in Massachusetts. And as many of you know, that's been Woody's passion, is to make sure that across the country there's a memorial to our Gold Star families to recognize their sacrifice. And it was actually a pretty extraordinary experience. Now, when I was going up there, I knew that I would see families from Iraq and Afghanistan. The individual who kind of coordinated the monument up there was the father of a Marine that supported us in 2003, and I knew several other families that were up there. And I knew there'd also be some Vietnam families that would be there as well. But I shared with Woody, you want to talk about the impact that his efforts have had and the impact really that many of you are part of. What I wasn't expecting to see was some World War II Gold families. And I'll just tell you a quick story about a torpedoman by the name of Larrabee. So he was a chief, and in 1939, Chief Larrabee retired from the United States Navy after 20 years. He went off and got a civilian job. And then Pearl Harbor occurred, and the first thing that Chief Larrabee did was make his way down to the recruiting station and say, hey, I'm available. I want to come back on active duty. And in 1942, Chief Larrabee was aboard the USS Barton off the coast of Guadalcanal. His ship was hit, and Chief Larrabee was killed. The day that I was there to dedicate this memorial that Woody had left behind, his children were there. 75 years later, his children were there, two boys and a girl. They were 8, 9, 6 years old at the time. And what happened that day was, you know, again, I think the families in the OIF, OEF stages, Iraq, Afghanistan, have been recognized, and I believe we can always do better, but I believe we've done all we can to embrace Gold Star families and make sure that they're part of our family forever. But that wasn't always the case. And it certainly wasn't the case back in World War II. But Woody, what you did that day was you actually reminded people from the World War II generation. And these children who for years grew up without their father, and honestly, I talked to them, they had not been part of almost anything in 75 years. Their dad died, they weren't living on a military installation. Their mom took 2 jobs, 3 jobs at a time to try to just get them through school and send them off their way. And the neighborhood never really recognized their sacrifice. They just went on about their lives. And as a result of your efforts, they became part of the Gold Star family. They became part of the community. And frankly, all of the rest of us were there, were reminded, one, of the cost of service. Here were some children that 75 years later, you think about all the things their dad missed over the years. Here they are in their 80s, and they hadn't seen, you know, they hadn't had a dad for all those years, and so that part of the sacrifice was certainly highlighted that day. But the other thing that I think I was most proud of was that there still are people like Woody, there still are people like the other recipients that are here, who really, when we say the words, your service matters, when we say the word, thank you for your service, when we say we really do mean it, when we say you're part of the family forever, well, those are only words unless you're actually doing the kinds of things that those of you in this room are doing, and if you're doing the kinds of things that what do you have done. So that Gold Star Memorial is about a lot more than a piece of granite. It's a beautiful piece of granite. It's about a lot more than a ceremony. It's a physical manifestation of the message that we actually do remember. We actually will never forget, and we actually do appreciate service. So, for Woody, for you, as the senior member of the recipients today, and for the president as well, who by billet is the senior member of the Medal of Honor recipients, it is for us, all of us, the chiefs, the senior enlisted, it's an extraordinary honor to just spend time with you. I mean, how many times do you go to an event and just look out to see 32 living Medal of Honor recipients? It's humbling. It's humbling. But the most important thing is not today's lunch. The most important thing to me is the loud and clear message you'll send about what our country is all about tomorrow. And I will tell you, I could not be more proud of each and every one of you for taking the time to do that. And I'll be, by the way, everyone I meet tomorrow, I'll be pointing you out where you're sitting, and I'll actually be telling them what it means. And I hope that message gets out across our country that what they are there for is to make sure that people do remember that this is about our nation. This is about the American people. This is about the greatest country in the world. And what I've been saying to people lately, and I'll close with this before introducing the Sea Chanters,